Good afternoon, students. So in the last class we have solved a few questions on integrals. So in today's class we'll continue with the next problem. So let us read out the question. Integral under root 1 plus sin x by 4 dx is equals to. So he has given four options. So let us solve this. So it is. So we'll write the given integral as I which is equals to integral under root 1 plus sine of x by 4 for dx. Now by making use of half angle formula, sine of x by 4 can be written as 2 sine x by 8 into cos x by 8, and in place of 1 I can write sin square x by 8 plus cos square x by 8. So I which is equals to integral under root sin square x by 8 plus cos square x by 8 plus, this can be written as 2 sin x by 8 into cos x by 8 into dx. So now a square plus b square plus 2ab, this can be written as a plus b the whole square. Integrals under root sin of x by 8 plus cos x by 8 the whole square dx. So here square and root get cancels. I which is equals to integral sin x by 8, integral sin x by 8 plus cos x by 8, it is dx. So now I which is equals to, what is the integration of sin x by 8 now? Minus cos x by 8 divided by 1 by 8, minus cos x by 8 whole divided by 1 by 8 plus, now integration of cos x by 8 will be sin x by 8 then whole divided by 1 by 8 plus c. Now this goes to the numerator. Now 8 goes to the numerator, here also 8 goes to the numerator. So here I can take 8 common, so that I will write it directly. I which is equals to, so 8 outside, inside the bracket, minus cos x by 8 plus sin x by 8 plus c. So search for the options now. It is 8 outside, see here, that means option D is eliminated. Here we have 1 by 8. Now the answer lies in a, b, c. So here it is minus cos x by 8, minus cos x by 8, that means the answer is option B, then plus sin x by 8 plus c. So this is all about the 11th problem. Well, the next question, it is 12th one. Integral 0 to pi by 2 cos x minus sin x divided by 1 plus cos x into sin x dx is equals to. So this was asked in 2004, and the previous question, 11th one, was asked in 2003. So let us solve this. So write the given integral now. I which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 cos x minus sin x, cos x minus sin x divided by 1 plus cos x into sin x dx. So now by making use of the property of definite integral, 0 to a f of x dx is equals to 0 to a f of a minus x dx, this can be written as I which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2 cos pi by 2 minus x minus sin pi by 2 minus x, sin pi by 2 minus x, then whole divided by 1 plus cos pi by 2 minus x, and then sine pi by 2 minus x dx. So now I, which is equals to integral 0 to pi by 2. So now cos 90 minus x, it is sine x, then minus sine 90 minus x, it is cos x, divided by 1 plus cos 90 minus x will be sin x. So it is sin x into, we get cos x dx. Now I take minus common in the numerator. I, which is equals to, so it is integral 0 to pi by 2 minus, you take it outside, we get cos x minus sin x, cos x minus sin x, divided by 1 plus sin x into cos x can be written as cos x into sin x, cos x into sin x dx. So call this as equation number 2, adding 1 and 2 now. Adding 1 and 2, I plus I will be 2i, which is equals to, so now see here, add the integral, I call this as 1. So we have to add the integral 1 and integral 2, cos x minus sin x divided by 1 plus cos x sin x, then minus of cos x minus sin x divided by 1 plus cos x sin x. So this is positive term, this is negative term, both get cancels if you add, and we get 0. So it is integral 0 to pi by 2 0 dx. So 2i, which is equals to 0, and I, which is equals to 0 by 2, that is also 0. Hence the answer is, it is option A. Well, the next question, it is 1 plus tan, integral 1 plus tan x divided by e raised to minus x cos x dx is equals to. So this question was asked in 2005. Let us solve this. So we'll write here. So we'll write the given integral now. I, which is equals to integral 1 plus tan x divided by e raised to minus x cos x dx. So now I, which is equals to integral, take this to the numerator, it becomes e raised to plus x, and then 1 by cos x will be secant x. So it is secant x, and write this term as it is 1 plus tan x dx. So now I, which is equals to integral e raised to x, write it as it is, then multiply secant x with these two terms, we get secant x plus secant x into tan x dx. So now see here, it is in the form of e raised to x f of x plus f dash of x dx. If that is the case, then the answer is e raised to x into f of x plus c. Therefore, I, which is equals to e raised to x into f of x. So this will be the f of x now. Secant x plus c. So this is the answer. Search for the options now. Now it is option c, e raised to x secant x plus c. Hence the answer is option c. Okay, the next question, it is 14th one, integral cosecant x divided by cos square into the bracket 1 plus log tan x by 2 dx is equal to. So this was asked in 2006. So let us solve this. So consider the given integral, I, which is equals to integral cosecant x divided by cos square into the bracket 1 plus log tan x by 2 dx. So here put 1 plus log 10x by 2, which is equals to t. So differentiate both the sides now. Derivative of 1 will be 0. Then we have to differentiate this. Log 10x by 2 will be 1 divided by 10x by 2. Then into derivative of 10x by 2 will be secant square x by 2. Secant square x by 2 into derivative of x by 2 will be 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 dx, which is equals to dt. So now see here, I write this 1 by 2 as it is, 1 divided by 2 as it is. Now 1 by 10 x by 2 will be cot x by 2. So and secant square x by 2 will be 1 divided by cos square x by 2. Cot x by 2 can be written as cos x by 2 divided by sin x by 2. And here one cos and one cos get cancelled. So you have one more cos x by 2 in the denominator. See here, I write sin x by 2 into cos x by 2 dx, which is equals to dt. So see here, 1 by 2, 2 into sin x by 2 cos x by 2 can be written as sin x. This is half angle formula. So 1 by sin x dx, which is equals to dt. What is 1 by sin? It is cosecant. So we get cosecant x dx, which is equals to dt. So this is nothing but the numerator. Cosecant x dx can be replaced with dt. So here the next step, it is I, which is equals to integral dt upon cos square t. This entire term is t. So what is 1 by cos square t? It is secant square t. Now I, which is equals to, so integral secant square t dt. So I, which is equals to integral secant square t, will be tan t plus c. So we get tan t plus c. Replace t now. Integral tan, what is t here? T is 1 plus log tan x by 2 plus c. So it is tan of 1 plus log tan x by 2. Hence the answer is option B. Okay, the next question, it is 15th one. Integral x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 divided by x plus 1 to the power 5 dx is equal to. So he has given the four options, and this question was asked in 2006. So let us solve this. So I consider this as I, which is equals to integral. See here, the numerator is nothing but x plus 1 the whole cube. It is x plus 1 the whole cube divided by x plus 1 to the power 5 dx. So now integral, so simplify this, we get 1 divided by x plus 1 the whole square dx. So expand this now, a plus b the whole cube, it is a cube. We have the first term, then second term will be 3 a square b. 3 a square, it is x square, b will be 1. So x square into 1, it is x square, plus 3 a b square. 3 write it as it is, a b square, 1 square will be 1, then plus b cube. That is why I have written a plus b the whole cube. So now I, which is equals to, it is in the form of integral 1 by x square dx. What is 1 by x square dx? It is minus 1 by x plus c. So minus 1 divided by x will be x plus 1 now plus c. So this is the answer. Search for the options now. Minus 1 divided by x plus 1 plus c. Hence the answer is option A. Well, the next question, it is 16th one. The value of integral x square plus 1 divided by x square minus 1 dx is, so this question was asked in 2007. So let us solve this. So I take the integral as I, which is equals to integral x square plus 1 divided by x square minus 1 dx. So now I which is equals to, so here in the numerator we have to make some adjustments. So I will add and subtract 1 here. So x square minus 1 plus 1 plus 1. This 1 at the end I have written as it is. Then I am subtracting and adding 1 here. Then divided by x square minus 1 dx. So now I which is equals to integral x square minus 1 plus 2 divided by x square minus 1 dx. So now I which is equals to, see here, split the denominator now. We get x square minus 1 divided by x square minus 1 plus 2 divided by x square minus 1. So we get integral dx plus integral 2 divided by x square minus 1 dx. So I have written it directly now. I am splitting the denominator. I am splitting the terms into two terms, and at the same time I am applying the integral. We get integral dx plus integral 2 by x square minus 1 dx. So now I which is equals to, what is integral of dx? It is x plus, take 2 outside. Now it is in the form of integral dx by x square minus a square. That will be 1 by 2a. A will be 1 here. So it is 2 into 1 into log mod x minus a divided by x plus a plus c. X minus a will be 1 divided by x plus a plus c. So 2 and 2 get cancels. The answer is I which is equals to x plus log x minus 1 divided by x plus 1 plus c. So search for the options now. X plus log x minus 1 by x plus 1 plus c. Hence the answer is option c. Well, the next question, it is 17th one. The value of integral minus 2 to plus 2 ax cube plus bx plus c dx depends on the value of b, and then the value of c, and then the value of a, and then the values of a and b. So this question was asked in 2008. Let us solve this. So I consider this as I which is equals to integral minus 2 to plus 2 ax cube plus bx plus c dx. So see the limits here. It is in the form of minus a to plus a. That means we have to go for the last property of the definite integrals. It depends on even or odd functions. So now we can split this into three integrals. So now these two are the odd functions. The first two are the odd functions. That means the value of these two integrals will be zero. So now it depends on only c, integral c dx. So that is why the answer is the value of c. So here ax cube and bx are odd functions. Therefore it depends on, therefore odd functions means the value of these two integrals will be zero. So now this, you know, value depends only on c now. So it depends on value of c. Hence the answer is the option b. So the next question, it is 18th one. Integral secant x divided by secant x plus tan x dx is equal to, the four options are tan x minus secant x plus c, then log 1 plus secant x plus c, then secant x plus tan x plus c, then log sin x plus log cos x plus c. So this was asked in 2008. Let us solve this. So I consider the given integral as I which is equal to integral secant x divided by secant x plus tan x dx. So now I which is equals to integral, so I multiply and divide by secant x minus tan x. So secant x into secant x minus tan x. So here secant x minus tan x I'll be dividing. So now a plus b into a minus b can be written as a square minus b square. That is in the denominator secant square x minus tan square x dx. So now I which is equals to integral, multiply this inside the bracket. Now we get secant square x minus secant x into tan x. Secant square x minus tan square x value will be 1. So we get dx. So I which is equals to integration of secant square x will be tan x, then minus integration of secant x into tan x will be secant x plus c. So search for the options now, tan x minus secant x plus c. Hence the answer is option A. Okay, the 19th question it is integral sin x into cos x dx divided by under root 1 minus sin raised to 4x is equal to. So this was asked in 2008. So let us solve the integral now. So I take the given integral as I which is equals to integral sin x into cos x divided by, so under root 1 minus sin raised to 4x dx. So now here put sin square x is equals to t, sin square x which is equals to t, then derivative of sin square x will be 2 sin x into cos x dx which is equals to dt. But here we need only sin x dx, that means take 2 to the RHS, it goes to the denominator. So sin x cos x dx which is equals to 1 by 2 into dt. Rewrite the integral now. I which is equals to 1 by 2, I write it outside, then dt divided by under root 1 minus, so sin raised to 4 can be written as sin square x the whole square. Sin square x we have taken it as t, that means it becomes t square. So now I which is equals to 1 by 2, write it as it is in the form of integral dx by under root 1 minus x square, that will be sin inverse x plus c. So here the variable is t, so we have to write sin inverse t plus c. So I which is equals to 1 by 2 sin inverse, 1 by 2 sin inverse, what is t here, it is sin square, it is sin square x plus c. So search for the options now, 1 by 2 sin inverse sin square x plus c. Hence the answer is option A. Well, the last question it is, if integral root x divided by x into x plus 1 dx which is equals to k into tan inverse m, then k comma m is, the four options are 2 comma x, 1 comma x, 1 comma root x and 2 comma root x. This question was asked in 2010. Let us solve this. So I take the given integral as I. So I which is equals to integral root x, integral root x divided by x into x plus 1 dx, x into x plus 1 dx. So now put x which is equals to tan square theta, put x equal to tan square theta. Now differentiate both the sides now. So what do we get? Dx which is equals to 2 tan theta into derivative of tan theta will be secant square theta d theta. So now rewrite the given integral. I which is equals to integral, so we have to get the value of root x, that means take square root on both the sides, so square and root get cancels, root x equal to tan theta. So in place of root x I can write tan theta, then divided by x into x plus 1, x will be tan square theta, so it is tan square theta. Then inside the bracket x plus 1, that is tan square theta plus 1, tan square theta plus 1 into dx. What is dx? It is 2 tan theta into secant square theta d theta. 2 tan theta into secant square theta into d theta. So see here, tan theta into tan theta will be tan square theta, and this tan square get cancels. So get cancels. Then tan square theta plus 1 or 1 plus tan square theta will be secant square theta from the basic identity of trigonometric functions. So 1 plus tan square theta and secant square theta get cancels. So which is the term that is left out now? It is integral 2 into d theta. So I which is equals to integral 2 into d theta. So now I which is equals to 2, write it outside, d theta will be theta plus c, theta plus c. Then I which is equals to 2, what is theta now? Theta will be, so tan inverse root x, tan inverse root x plus c, tan inverse root x plus c. But see here, the value of this will be k tan inverse m. So but integral root x divided by x into x plus 1 dx, which is equal to k tan inverse m. So compare this now, the value after solving the integral we got this answer. So now compare this with this. So on comparing with above result we get, see here, in place of k we have 2, we get k is equals to 2 and then m which is equals to root x. Therefore the answer is, we need k comma m now, it is 2 comma root x. So search for the options now, 2 comma root x, it is the option D. So this is all about today's class.